Annual ryegrass is the world champion of herbicide resistance. It has developed resistance to more herbicides faster than any other weed on the planet. Every 5 years or so, AHRI with GRDC Investment conducts a statewide random survey. Michelle Owen, one of our AHRI researchers, leads that survey now. Her last survey was in 2015, sampled in 2015. The survey shows that for some of our older herbicides, they had very high levels of resistance years ago, and that's still the case. So our SUs and our FOPs in the high 90s for resistance. So even though it plateaued at almost 100% resistance. So that's not big news. What was interesting was clethodim was around about that 40% resistance level in the 2010 survey and is about 44% of our populations in Western Australia have clethodim resistance to the high rate of clethodim. A couple of the other important herbicides, trifluralin was at around about 27, 28% resistance in 2010. Now about 30% of our populations in Western Australia have trifluralin resistance. So that, even though it plateaued a little bit, that's big news. That's a big problem coming for Western Australian grain growers. With a random survey, it can be hard to find resistance with these surveys. With a random survey, roughly a 1 in 3 chance that you've got trifluralin resistance. That's a big threat. And glyphosate resistance, while it's only at about 8% in ryegrass in a random survey, if we do a more targeted survey, we find much higher levels of glyphosate resistance. The good news is there's still a lot of herbicides at work. We've had a suite of new herbicides come out of our pre-ems, Sakura, Boxer Gold, Propizamide, those sorts of herbicides. We don't have resistance in those yet. We didn't find any paraquat resistance, so we still have an effective knockdown herbicide. So we do still have a suite of herbicides that are available to our grain growers. We used to talk a lot about rotating herbicides. So if we used one herbicide last year, don't use it next year. Now we more talk about mixes. Mix two herbicides this year and mix another two herbicides next year. So the mix and rotate message. So rotating is still a good idea, but mixing two herbicides together is even better. And it doesn't even have to be in the same tank. It can be a good pre-em with a good post-em herbicide, but it's all about double knocks. Can we get two hits at the same weed with multiple herbicides? We can end up with lots of trifluralin. So we could end up with, say, trifluralin Sakura 1 year, trifluralin Propizabide the next, trifluralin Boxer Gold the year after that. It sounds bad having trifluralin in all of those years, all in one rotation, whereas in the past we used to say, if you used it last year, don't use it this year. Whereas we're more comfortable now saying that's okay to overuse, say, perhaps a product like trifluralin if it's effective on your farm, as long as it's mixed with another effective herbicide and or has those second knocks in the system. And those second knocks can come in the way of an effective post-emergent herbicide and good crop competition and stopping seed set and harvest weed seed control. Our WeedSmart Big Six, in a nutshell, is to rotate crops and pastures. It's to double knock to preserve glyphosate, mix and rotate our herbicides, grow competitive crops, stop seed set wherever we can, and use harvest weed seed control. That's a lot to take in one mouthful, but that is the WeedSmart Big Six, and you can find more information on that on the WeedSmart website. We've seen huge success in growers that have used all the tactics, but also used harvest weed seed control. They've got their weed numbers down and they're keeping them down for a long period of time. And these growers are continuous cropping and confident about the future of continuous crop because their seed banks are just so low. What's going on with this cross resistance? Even though there's some different groups of herbicide in there, we are finding that there is metabolic resistance, likely due to P450 enzymes that can give resistance across a range of herbicides. And so what do we do with that? Well, that is probably worst case scenario. And so what we need to do is we need to use that information and then develop the best mix and rotate herbicide messages that we can with all of that in mind.